2010 Michel Schlumberger Pinot Blanc. This comes to us in the Dry Creek Valley in Sonoma. On the nose, we're getting pear puree, dark honey, apricot pastry with a bit of lavender. On the palate, it's really bright and beautiful on the greeting, and then it transitions to something a bit more smooth and balanced on the mid palate. The finish? There's a farewell there, not easily forgotten. Cheers to a fabulous Pinot Gris. Black Star Farms 2010 Arcturos Dry Riesling. This comes to us from Michigan. Honeysuckle, ripe cantaloupe, white lilies, and warm, golden, delicious apples. So if this wine was a singer, it'd be a soprano. You've got these really bright flavors that are all harmonized on the palate. With really sharp acid that's really beautiful. So, cheers to a soprano of a Riesling. 2010 Lamoureux Landing Riesling. This comes to us from the Red Oak Vineyard in the Finger Lakes region of New York. So, on the nose, we're getting tapioca pudding, tangerine, Granny Smith apple, and lime. So on the palate you have these vivid flavors that are supported by a solid amount of acid. And the character stays consistent across the palate, start to finish. Cheers to that. 2009 Wagner Vineyards Semi-Dry Riesling. This comes to us from the Finger Lakes of New York. On the nose, red carnations, not the pink ones, peach pie, key lime, and citrus salad with grapefruit and oranges and tangerines and all of it. On the palate, you have this beautifully blinding acid. With a solid dose of green apple on the mid palate and on the finish. Cheers to a dynamic Riesling. 2010 Red Newt Cellars Circle Riesling. This comes to us from the Finger Lakes region of New York. On the nose, intense tart cranberry, Earl Grey, raspberry syrup, and dried rose petals. The bouquet on the nose is presented again at the palate. And medium body with a presence that is carrying some acid with it to support its posture. I love it. I love it. Cheers to that. The 2009 William Hill Estate Winery. Their Chardonnay comes from Napa Valley. On the nose, we have green pear, coconut custard pie, vanilla extract, And lemon cake. I have this toasted oak and lemon bar that are balanced by a level of acid that stretches itself across the finish on the wine. Cheers to an interesting Chardonnay. 2009 Bridalwood Chardonnay, and this comes from Monterey County, California. On the nose, creme brulee, lemon tart, French vanilla, and ripe pineapple. It's bright to start and pretty bold to finish. This is a Chardonnay that practices on the palate what it preaches on the nose. Cheers to practicing what you preach. 2008 Terra Valentine Amore. I think the name speaks for itself. Because on the nose you have homemade oatmeal cookies, dark brown sugar, red cherries, and dark cranberries. On the palate, you have a solid degree of tannin that serves as a foundation, and bright acid that frames in the palate. The flavors I noted just a moment ago resurface once again on the finish. Cheers to Amore. Cheers to being in love with a fabulous red wine from Napa. 2008 Waitz Mask Pinot Noir. This comes to us from the Russian River Valley. On the nose, sharp cranberry, black plum and baking spices with rose petal potpourri. On the palate, red cherry spice and raspberry sorbet. Those start you out, and the cranberry finishes you up on the palate. Cheers to that. We have the 09 R. Stewart & Company Big Fire Pinot Noir. This comes to us from Oregon. Cherry raspberry chutney, homemade pumpkin bread, and dried rose petals. As if what it was doing on the nose was not enough, on the palate, it offers those same intense flavors, but it's infused with this level of acid that makes it quite lovely. Cheers to lovely Pinot.